Welcome to Honda 5 Sports Live, everyone. I'm Paxton Boyd from ESPN 106.3. We've got a great show lined up for you tonight. An iconic cartoon character gets inducted into the Major League Baseball Hall of Fame. NFL celebrations are back, and Boca Raton resident Bernhard Langer entered the day just one shot off the lead, looking for his ninth senior major title. But let's begin on the tennis court. It's opening rounds for the French Open. One name that we know is not there, Palm Beach Gardens resident Serena Williams, who is, of course, in the process of becoming a new mom. That could open up a chance for sister Venus to make it to her first French Open final in 15 years. Venus taking on Chang Wang in her 20th French Open. We begin with the first set. Williams down 4-3. Wang hits the return wide, and we are tied up at 4 games apiece. Now Venus now up 5-4. She comes charging, hits the soft shot over the net for the point. She would take the first set 6-4. Now we move to the second set. Venus looking to take a 6-5 lead, hits the backhand winner and just nicks the end line for the point. Wang, she can't believe it. Williams goes up 6-5. Venus would end up winning 7-6 and advances to the next round of the French Open. From the clay courts to the clay diamond, St. Lucie taking on Clearwater this afternoon. Top of the sixth, no runs scored. Clearwater on the attack. Zach Coppola will come in to score off from third off of the pass ball. The Threshers take a 1-0 lead just like that. Now let's move ahead to the bottom of the eighth. Mets still down 1-0. Dan Rizzi up to bat, connects, sends this one to left field. He's thinking two, but plays it safe, stays at first for the single. But the Mets can't take advantage with the runner on. Jeff Singer gets Vinny Sienna swinging to end the inning. St. Lucie still trails 1-0. Then in the bottom of the ninth for the Mets, the last chance to make something happen. Singer strikes out Johan Urena to end the game. The Mets would fall 1-0. Well, members of the 1992 Springfield Nuclear Plant softball team now include Baseball Hall of Fame famers Ken Griffey Jr., Wade Boggs, and Ozzie Smith. And now, wait for it, Homer J. Simpson. That's right, Homer Simpson, the cartoon character, beat out Roger Clemens, Daryl Strawberry, and Don Mattingly to be inducted in Cooperstown. The induction helping celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Simpsons episode Homer at the Bat, which aired in 1992 and features several other Hall of Famers. Even Ozzie Smith and Wade Boggs were on hand this weekend to help induct Homer. Maybe Simpson's biggest contribution to the game, Homer saved the Springfield Isotopes, their minor league team, from moving to Albuquerque. So what does this generation of players think about Simpson getting in the hall? Well, we decided to find out.
Well deserved. The guy's a grinder, man. It's been a long time coming, a lot of years on television, and he just gets it done. He goes out there, makes people laugh every day. So, you know, hats off to Homer Simpson.
The backfields at Roger Dean Stadium playing host to the Under Armour Memorial Day Classic. 40 teams competing to take home first place, but also to impress scouts and receive an invitation to the Under Armour National Showcase. A cool new feature this year is the Easton Hitting Simulator. The system is set up where scouts can see how far and how hard the players hit the ball. The program uses exact specifications of major league stadiums like Marlins Park, so kids can see if they have what it takes to go yard in a big league ballpark.
Yeah, it's definitely a cool little thing, and we have all the correct dimensions loaded up, so you know you're not actually there, but it gets you within 5 feet of what you would if you were there. I mean, we have one in the office, and we mess around at, you know, LA Stadium, Dodger Stadium, and but yeah, it's cool to have, and we have about, I think, 25 places right now, so just to get the kids fired up.
Well, if you haven't heard, we're about to enter or perhaps re-enter an era in which the NFL stops taking itself so seriously. An era in which Roger Goodell isn't completely consumed by punishing players. An era that will once again allow its players to celebrate on the field. Where the league finally loosens its belt, puts its feet up on the couch, and just chills the heck out. That's right, the No Fun League is now fun again. Celebrations are back. At least for the most part. There's still no twerking, no gyrating. Sorry about that, Antonio Brown. But hey, it's a start. And you know what? It's about time. Commissioner Goodell is doing everything he can to demoralize these players and squeeze every dime out of them. 4 preseason games isn't fun. 35-0 blowouts on Thursday nights. Those aren't fun either. But you know what is? Barreling over a 250-pound linebacker and pounding your chest. Lining up with your teammates in the end zone to take an imaginary photo. Proposing to a cheerleader. I mean, come on, you just scored a touchdown in the National Football League against the 0.01%. You may never do it again. Let them go crazy, let them go wild, and if you want to hand the ball off to the official and act like you've been there before, then by all means, that's fine too. But make no mistake about it, these are the guys who entertain us. Entertain being the operative word for hours upon hours every Sunday in the fall, and they're the ones who risk injury or worse to do it. At least give them the freedom to make that decision.